This is Melissa with Atlas CFO, and we are continuing with our understanding contractor financial statements, and today we are looking at an income statement. So we've looked at a balance sheet, and now we're going to look at an income statement. And we want to make sure that we start with the balance sheet because we are making sure that we have those two accounts, maybe four accounts, that all have related to the timing difference. So now we get to look at the income statement. And if you cheat and you look at the income statement first, you may just have to turn right back around and look at it again if you haven't made sure you don't have those two accounts. Okay, so now let's look at our income statement. So we have, I've got a really, really simple version. You know that I'm really teaching theory, not actuals here. So we've got an example contractor. And this is an $8 million contractor, and I've just got a few of the accounts that you would expect to see, but this isn't exact science. Every contractor has a little bit different chart of accounts, and they certainly handle their allocation of burden differently. So we're just going to go with theories and some big things that you're going to want to pull off the income statement. Now, I am showing this particular current work in progress adjustment account. You will not typically see that. What I wanted to point out here is typically it is bound up in revenue and you don't see the adjustment. I've made an adjustment for you. It will not tie to the job schedule. So you will have an adjustment. So let's assume that we've got those two accounts up on our balance sheet. Well, now we've got an account usually embedded in our revenue and it doesn't tie to the job schedule because in this account you see the ins and outs. It's the activity for the whole year. So you really can't tie it out to the job schedule. So once we've got that, let's move on. So in this particular example, we have some direct costs. Now what direct cost is the job cost that ties and is used for the job cost and the job schedule. So this is a good theory idea, is that you should be able to go down to your gross margin right here, because I've given you a little sample gross margin, and it should be close to your job schedule. It's not exact, it's usually just close. And if you see something like really one way or the other, usually you want to ask a few more questions. So today I'm giving you one that's close, but maybe you'd have a few questions to ask. So let me show you. Let's go over to our job schedule, and you can see here on our job schedule, we are actually producing about a 14% margin on our open work in progress. So again, this is just open work, so this is what's currently open as of our date, and we're showing 14%. However, if we look at our income statement, we're showing 12%. So this might cause you to ask a few questions, and they're good questions to ask. You want to know whether you have had trending up in the gross margin. Clearly, we have open work that is doing better than our historical performance at 12%. But is there something else going on? Is there other current work that is not on the job schedule, such as small service work, that could be affecting this? Is there a job that hasn't made it to the job schedule? Are we missing a job on the job schedule? So you can see I've got just a couple of questions that might be worth asking. You can ask all kinds of trending questions now that you know these two numbers, but there could be something else that is affecting this, and that is our lovely burden or indirect allocation. So let me show you what I mean. Right here below, I've created a fake group of accounts that would relate to burden and indirect. Now, we actually have a whole nother series just on this topic, and we probably could spend 4 hours just talking about it. It is very interesting, and people love to hate it. And there is definitely some strong opinions about how to handle this, and our version is really just a version. So this is just an example, just for playing along. But we have created an indirect group of accounts. And I'm going to show you something right here that might make you ask a few more questions, and you might just have to call me if you have some questions. So what we've got is a list of accounts that we would consider something we might want to allocate above the line. So the line is this. This is the line, gross profit. And whenever you hear somebody talk about above the line or below the line, that's the line. So what we do is we take all these accounts and we use a function typically in the software. If it is a full construction-based software, QuickBooks, you have to do this manually. So if it is a full construction-based software, there is a method to be able to allocate these type of costs up into your job costs. So this is one way, especially if you've got a QuickBook user, that you can have very different job cost and income statement, because they could have done some sort of an allocation that is really behind the scenes. If you're dealing with true job cost contractor software, Timberline, now Sage, Computeries, Foundation, Viewpoint, Maxwell, like Cheney Dexter, there's a whole bunch of them. If you are dealing with a true contractor software, usually this function is done for you. However, it can dramatically affect the income shown for gross profit. The real point of you asking this question is you want to make sure they're using apples and apples. So you want to make sure they're using the same basis of cost on the job schedule that they are for the income statement. And just by comparing that gross margin, you'll be able to have those next questions to be able to ask them what they're doing with it, how they're doing with it, and you can have some really great conversation. Now, if this contractor is not using an accountant that is comfortable talking about construction accounting, this is a difficult conversation, so that you might even need to get some help. Having an outside accountant that is very fluent in construction makes a huge difference on these types of things. Okay, that's all I really wanted to point out today, was how you can make the income statement and the job schedule make sense together. Thank you for joining me. Talk to you soon.